Howdy. We're talking about suspended chords today, particularly the D suspended chords. Now remember where our regular D chord is. Normally we have our index finger on the third string in the second fret, middle finger is on the first string in the second fret, and the ring finger is on the second string in the third fret. And that we play the first through fourth strings. Okay, to get the D suspended second, all we do is we take this same chord position where we're at with the D major, and we just lift the middle finger. So that leaves our index finger and our ring finger still in the same positions that they were. So we just lift the middle finger. So this is the D, and the D suspended two with the middle finger lifted. Check yourself by picking each string individually. It should ring clearly. Okay, and then to get to the D suspended four, we have a pinky. See our pinky sitting here just floating in space, it's doing nothing. Well, we're going to now use it. We're going to drop that pinky onto the first string, but in the third fret. So we go from the D major, we drop the pinky down on the first string in the third fret, and it adds that high tone. That's the fourth note. That's what your D suspended four should sound like. Pinky lifted. That's the D major, pinky down. That's the D suspended four. When you get comfortable with that, you should be practicing a few strums of each and start to alternate back and forth between them. Like spices. Use it sparingly and it really adds to the artistry of your music. Use it too much, it can be a little bit off-putting. But it's kind of like adding lace to a design. It's an accoutrement to be added. Not something to be lived on exclusively. All right, and that's the D suspended two and D suspended four chords.